So the cloud is made to be simple to configure, right? So you would expect that configuring channel and power would be simple as well. Well, actually it is. The way you do it is that you go to wireless and there is something called radio settings. Just click there. And then you see the list of your access points. Let me go down a little bit and show you what we have. So you have your list of your access points, and whenever you click any of the access points, you can see its settings on the right side. So here you can decide of the channel width, and you can also decide of the channel itself. You set it to auto, which is going to use a form of RRM to automatically assign the channels to your different access points. And as you can see here on the 2.4 band, I'm using 1, 6 and 11. Or you can also set the channel manually if you decide to do so. Typically, people would keep it, you know, with RRM because it's more dynamic. The same goes for power. You can choose the power dynamically or set it statically. When you choose the power automatically, you have this option at the top. That is to say, try to use all the power you can as often as you can. Or if you want your APs to shrink down their power because you are in a high density environment and you don't want too much overlap between the cells, you can set to enable automatic power reduction, which is what you would do in a typical enterprise environment where you have a good overlap and a high density of access points. Let me click save so you can have the validation of these settings. When you set the auto channel, you can decide to use all the band or also exclude the DFS channels. When you do that, you exclude the Unit 2 and Unit 2 extended channels that are affected by DFS, which avoids that you have to move away from a channel because of radar blast interference. When you look at your access points, the nice thing in this interface is that you can see a list as we have here. And again, every time you click an access point, you get its values on the right side and you can change it. You can also, if you want to, see the access points on the map. And if you set your access points in the location where you have your network, you can see those access points on the map. So this is a small network. Let me show you a larger network. And go back to the map. So in this view, you can see not only the building and the access points, but you can also see from Google Map where the building is set. And you can, of course, zoom out if you want to have a larger view of the campus, or zoom in if you want to see the map of your floor. You can also remove the satellite view if you don't like it. And then if you have several floors, of course, you can decide which floor you want to have a look at. That's very nice because you have a heat map view of which cell is going to cover which part of your building. You can have this view for 2.4, and you can switch it, of course, to 5 GHz, where you have the same view with the different channels. For each of those, of course, you can click the access points, and on the right side, you will see the same values as before, that is to say the channel width and the power location. So they said it would be easy, and yes, it's very easy.